To have for you and you. Oh, let's go. But you want it so bad, and you gotta get them back. Say, oh, oh, it won't get no better until you want it again. To say, oh.
What's up, y'all? It's your girl, the real Shotzie. Let me take my hater shades off. What's up, everybody? How's everybody doing? How has your week been so far? It's hump day. Don't try to hide from the camera. It's hump day. It's past hump day. It's pre-TGIF. Tomorrow is Friday. Are y'all ready for it? Hope y'all got something nice planned for the weekend, because the weather is supposed to be like redonkulous, all up in the high 60s and 70s and stuff like that. It was supposed to be raining, and I guess that's kind of moved its little way out and everything like that. So it's going to be some pretty decent weather this weekend. You know what I'm saying? So I'm definitely going to be getting out. Not sure what I'm going to be doing, but I'm going to be getting out. So hope y'all got something nice planned and everything like that. How's everybody's week been? What's been going on? Let me say happy birthday to Aaron E. Shout out to you. Happy birthday. It's your birthday. And I don't know if I want to mention your name. I got your email though. So, but yeah, so I hope everybody's been doing so good. You're here. That means that you're not in jail, which means you had your bail money saved up. I'm so proud of y'all. Like, y'all are just growing up before my very eyes. Like, I just, This is what a mom must feel like to see her kids just growing up and just, you know, moving so fast in life. I'm so proud of you guys. So, anywho, so I was not sure what we were going to talk about today, but I actually got a pretty good idea. I'm going to have a special guest on tonight, so I hope y'all are ready for it. And I'm going to get to that in a second. Just, y'all ain't ready. But yeah, so this week has been pretty good for me. Man, it's gone by so quickly. I feel like Vegas is like just right around the corner. I know, here you go again. Oh, you're going to Vegas. It's not that fun when you have to be there for 2 weeks and you don't live there, okay? You get tired of Vegas after usually about the third day. Actually, about 2 days, because it's really only like two things to do, gamble and party. And you can kind of do that at home. It's just that Vegas is a little bit more glitzy and glittery and, you know, all that other good stuff. So, but yeah, so I'll be there for 2 weeks and that time frame is coming up so quickly. So, not even ready for that. Anybody who follows me on my social media, I just posted today the flyer for the show next month. So if you are in the Atlanta area, definitely come check it out on the 19th at the Atlanta Comedy Theater. Y'all are not ready for this live TV. That's what it's called. It's called live TV because it's going to be off the chain. It's going to be hilarious. We've got a really great cast, some really funny people. And I always like to relate it back to In Living Color because that's kind of what it's like. So it's just going to be hilarious. And I'm looking forward to it. So if anybody is in the Atlanta area on March 19th, flyer is on my social media. Make sure you come check out your girl and all her crazy castmates and just see what's going down because it's going to be good. So I'm not going to hold y'all up with little riffraff talk tonight because I'm so excited about tonight's show, y'all. So what we're going to be talking about tonight is, you know how you have that person, you know, whether it be friend or family member in your life, and they always just seem to be causing some kind of turmoil, drama, some shiggity. Like, it just does not matter what it's about. They just always causing some kind of shiggity, whether they personally causing it or they're inciting themselves in a situation to cause it. That's what we're talking about tonight. And we are using my family as an example. Y'all thought I was crazy. So these are the type of people that they gossip and they're always just starting stuff. You can't tell them nothing because it's like, if you tell them something, it's getting told to everybody. Like, doesn't matter what it is. Yes, hello, mother.
Hey.
What are you doing? Okay, well, you're going to need to turn that down because you've got a show to do here now. No, I'm just calling you because I like to talk to you. Yes, we're on now. I mean, we've been talking about this all day long, and she's sitting here asking, oh, is it on now? Oh, is that today?
Stop the show.
Oh.
So what now?
Nothing. I ain't say anything.
I need to log on?
No, you don't need to log on. I mean, they can hear you.
We haven't rehearsed or anything. You're not on there yet, are you?
Ma, it's not a rehearsal. We're just supposed to be talking about a little gossipy, you know, friends and family members and how we have a code Medea in our family. That's it. It's not rocket science. You're not, you know.
They want to hear me?
Yes, they can hear you.
Do I click join the show?
I mean, you can click join the show if you want to. Y'all see what I have to go through? Now, let me just clarify some things for y'all, because I know probably some of y'all are probably sitting back like, oh my God, like, why is she talking to her mother like that? Let me explain something to you. My mother is a doctor, okay? She has a doctorate's degree. She has a PhD, okay? She has a bachelor. She has an associate. She has a myriad of masters, and she is still about as clueless as a clue. I don't know. I'm sorry. Let me scale that back so they can't hear me talking about you.
How do I get to where you are?
I mean, you just have to join the show.
I did join the show.
Did you? Did you really?
I had to pay to join the show?
You don't have to pay to join. Oh, you mean to talk on it? Yeah, you kind of do.
You can't get it to come up.
Y'all see what I have to go through. Somebody is missing out on some serious money on this family. And this is just my mom. Like,
you haven't logged on yet, have you?
Yes, I have.
Huh?
Yes, I have.
Why can't I see it?
I don't know. Are you on the phone or the computer?
Oh, maybe because I'm on the phone with you.
This is what I'm talking about, people. This is the doctorate right here. The PhD right here. I'm sorry.
The joke is over.
I'm sorry. You can still hear me?
Yes, I can still hear you. Can you hear me? Can we hear me?
Yeah, they can hear you.
Okay, go ahead. Do the talk.
I mean, we've already kind of gotten you out of the way. Now, y'all, don't be fooled by my mama, because my mama can be just as messy sometimes. Now, she's not as messy as my aunt is, but she... Don't let this voice fool you, okay? So, y'all, today's topic, as I said, we're talking about messy people in your life, whether they be friend, family, or foe. We've all got them. Some of them we can't get rid of as easily as we'd like to, but they're there. So, we have one of those members, and she's an interesting case, to say the least. Where is she at right now?
She went to bingo.
She went to bingo.
She went with Gail, so I'm just praying that there are no fireworks.
Okay, so here's another tip for you guys. If you have family members in your family that are close to retiring, do not let them retire, because they have nothing better to do. My mom's getting ready to retire, and I'm not very happy about that. What?
Go ahead.
I'm not very happy about that, because now she's retired. All of her sisters are retired, which means they have nothing better to do. And what do people with nothing better to do?
Keeping other people alive.
I'm not ready for this.
We get other people alive. I know how to be just as messy as Melanie is.
So you're actually saying that you're planning on being messy?
Yeah, she's making a lot of fun.
Why?
I ain't gonna have nothing else to do.
Okay, so do I need to like pop out a child or something so that you can be busy?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure about that.
I mean, I'm pretty sure my people would be accommodating to the situation.
No. I'm gonna be on the road. I'm gonna be doing things, going places, seeing people.
On the road where?
Well, you know, visit people, visit family, and find out. I'm going to bring Marilyn with me so,
you know,
she makes all the right questions to find out about their business and everything.
You do know Auntie Marilyn gets you in most of the trouble that you are always in.
All my life.
I'm not saving up any bail money for y'all. I'm just kind of throwing that out there.
Oh, no, we don't go that far in trouble. That's past fun. Then it's no fun when you start getting in trouble.
It depends.
Yeah, it depends on whether you want to be looking for some bars, and I never have, and never will, and never want to.
Let's congratulate her, folks. She's never been arrested for somebody who likes to cause as much trouble as she does. And you got a hand clap. You should be appreciative of that.
Somebody gave me a hand clap?
Yes, somebody gave you a hand clap.
Yay.
Where's Daddy at?
And they're watching a movie with the kids.
What movie are y'all watching?
Ghostbusters.
I mean, is that like a kid-friendly movie?
I don't know. I've never seen it. That's why we're watching it.
Did you look at the rating?
No. They've seen it before. I haven't seen it.
So y'all, all my life, I've always been saying that I was kidnapped and placed on their doorstep, and they have raised me ever since. And not only on tonight's show, but next week when we have our additional special guest on Tuesday's show, you're going to see how different I am from my family. I'm still looking for my royal family because I know they are out.
You're not that different. You're just as messy as the rest of them.
I am not. What are you talking about? I'm the one that people call to tell stuff to.
I have to put out a disclaimer when I tell you things that I know. Like, I said, I'm going to tell you this, but don't tell nobody because you're always talking with Marilyn.
No, I don't. Who have I ever told anything to?
Well, see, I just didn't come back to you with it when I had told you something one time and you told Marilyn. Marilyn came back and told me that you told her. I'm like, no, she didn't.
Ma, really?
Really?
What?
Okay, now I know I have to put that disclaimer out there.
What was it that you told me? I mean, because if you didn't say, hey, this is not supposed to go beyond me and you, I mean, it's kind of, you know, people logic that it's not a secret unless you say this is a secret.
Well, maybe the words, I'm going to tell you this, but don't tell nobody.
You didn't tell me that.
All right, Chelsea. That's the disclaimer right there. Messy people use. You're telling me not to tell about Marilyn. They don't say that. You tell Marilyn something, and you think you're talking with her in confidentiality, you know, and you say, okay, I got something to tell you. And then if you don't say, don't tell nobody, the next thing you know, somebody calls you like, what's up with this? What's up with that? Who told you that? Marilyn?
Okay.
And you call her and say, why did you tell them? You didn't tell me not to tell nobody.
Everybody knows you don't tell Auntie Marilyn anything unless you want everybody else to know. There is no disclaimer with her.
Telegram and tell Marilyn.
Y'all see what I have to go through? Like, y'all, they are just missing so much drama on TV. So much. And this is just the phone call. Y'all couldn't imagine what it's like being in person. Like, being in person is like, it's just, it's reality
TV.
Now,
they are the real. You might think you're the real Shotzi or whatever, but they are the real people. You know what? They say 100.
I'm sorry. I'm feeling a little shade here. Are you trying to say that I'm not real?
I'm saying where you got your realness from.
Didn't I get my realness from Mama?
No. Well, yeah, because, you know, the oranges don't fall far off the apple tree.
Oranges don't grow on apple trees. all right, Mother. Well, this has been interesting. I'm going to get back to the show now.
Okay, and I'm going to get off the phone and tune in, and we'll tune in next week with the rest of your viewers, and we will have our very special guest, our messy family member.
You know, I'm wondering if we should do like a face chat thing.
No.
Why not? Like, somebody could be watching this and recording this, and then they go put it on YouTube. Bam. Instant YouTube stars. Then they're knocking down our doors because they want a reality show with this crazy family. I mean, they're going to be like, boo, boo, who?
Well, we'll see. In due time. We'll give them some comedy because there is plenty of comedy in this family, especially when there's a gaggle of them together.
All right, Mommy dearest. Go back and enjoy your movie.
All right.
I'm going to get through the rest of this show here. But thank you for tuning in and being a part of the show tonight. Everybody give her a round of applause.
Yay. I'll be back next week with my messy twin sister.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Cato.
Love you, Dr. Cato.
Love you too. Bye.
Bye.
Y'all just don't understand. Like, she has so many degrees, and there's just something, like, it's just not screwed tight up there. It's just not. There's so much rattling around that you hear. Like, you shake her head, and you know how, like, you have, like, that piggy bank, and you have that one penny in it that you just cannot get out, and you rattle it around, and you rattle around. You can hear it but you just cannot get it out. That is my mother. I love her dearly. Hope she's not watching this.
Love you, mommy. I mean it.
So anyway, like she was saying, next week we are going to have the messy member of the family on the show. And she's just going to give you the lowdown on how to be messy and what it's like to be messy, because we all have those people in our lives, whether we want them there or not. And a lot of the times, I will admit that, you know, sometimes people don't know they're doing it, or they're not intentionally doing it, but they're doing it. And so it's like, how do you deal with those people? Here is my advice for you. Take this, write it down, learn it, live it, breathe it. If you have these people in your family or in your life, once you understand who and or what a situation is, you're better able to deal with it. I understand that my aunt is messy and that she likes to start stuff and then sit back and laugh at it. I understand that that's who she is. I understand that she almost died because she had no gossip in her life to tell anybody. She had no one to talk about. And then here's another thing. You can call her and be like, hey, auntie, what's going on? Hey, nothing, what's going on? Nothing, I was just calling you saying, hey. Oh, well, you ain't got nothing to talk about, so I'm going to go back to sleep.
What the hell?
So rude. Just so rude. So rude and disrespectful. If you don't have any drama or any gossip for her, she doesn't want to talk to you. She don't want to sit on the phone and talk about how your day is, how your job is going, what you've been doing, how are you. She don't want to hear none of that. She wants to know what's juicy. If you ain't got nothing juicy, she don't want to talk to you. Now, my mom is the same way. Oh my God, they're so rude. Like, I don't know where they get their manners from. I'll call my mom and I'll be like, hey, mom, what's up? Oh, nothing. And we'll be talking and everything like that. All right. Well, the next call coming in. So you either going to have to get back to the back of the line or I'll talk to you later.
What the devil? Where they do that at?
They're just so rude and disrespectful. Just don't care. And it's like, so I'm going to do a DNA test and I'm going to find my true royal family out there, because I know my royal family is out there. I know they are out there somewhere. And I got mixed up. And the butler was drunk, and he, instead of dropping off the groceries, dropped me off. And at that point, I was already stolen and sold, and they couldn't trace me down. And then my family changed my name, and here I am today. I'm coming for you, family. I'm looking for you. I will find you. I love them to death. I do. We all have that family. Or, you know, some people can relate, but I'm just telling y'all, like, they are on a totally different plane. And it's like, and it's funny because if I bring people home, like friends or anything, oh my God, your family is so much fun. They're so cool. Really? Are we looking at the same people? You mean them over there? You can't be talking about that. Have you been drinking? Like, I have to, did they harm you in any way? Did they threaten you or your family? Like, you know, it's just, they're crazy. But we do have a good time. We always have fun when we get together. It's always like a big party, no matter how many are there. It could be 5 of us. It could be 50 of us. We always have fun. So that's a good thing. So don't disown your family just because they're different. Still do your DNA test on the Lolo. That way, if it comes back that you are actually related to them, you don't hurt anybody's feelings. Now, if it comes back that you are not related to them and you belong to somebody else, then that's a whole nother show, isn't it? But, you know, just learn who they are, accept them, maybe not take them out in public, but accept them. Maybe not broadcast that you're related, but accept them. And, you know, just keep it moving. So, but next week we are going to have both the clueless doctor and her illustrious messy twin back on next week. So y'all make sure to definitely tune in on Tuesday. It's going to be funny. Just to prepare you, my aunt is very short and it may not be a PG-ish show. Just say it like that. Maybe, you know, bordering on rated R. So if you're tuning in on Tuesday, I apologize for that in advance. But it's definitely going to be funny. And you may hear some family drama. You may hear, you know, something may be aired. I don't know. You just never know what's going to come out of my aunt's mouth. She'll definitely talk about me because that's what she does. She talks about everybody. Sweetest person in the world. Let me stop saying that. Sweet as can be. I really need a good way to describe her. She can be sweet. Say it like that. Yeah, there we go. We got it with it. Chicken, winter dinner. Can be sweet. Will give you the shirt off of her back, but will talk about you as she's giving you that shirt. So be prepared for it. So I hope you guys have something very great planned for the weekend. It's going to be nice out. So make sure you get out there, wash your car, hang out in the park, just sunbathe, whatever it is. But make sure you get out there and enjoy the weather before it either disappears or starts getting stupid hot. And then like you can't even go outside without a freaking suit on from burning up from the atmosphere or whatever. But make sure you get out and enjoy it. And I'm going to find something to eat because I'm hungry again. And have a good weekend. Stay out of trouble. Make sure you got your bail money set aside for Tuesday because you do not want to miss Tuesday's show. It's going to be off the chain, as Melby likes to say. So definitely going to have a good time. And maybe we'll rehearse before we come on. I don't even know what that means. I let her into a few sets and now she's like throwing around lingo like she actually knows what it means. Anyway, as always, love you, be you, do you. See you guys on Tuesday. Stay out of trouble until then, or at least have your bail money set up so that you could be here. Definitely keep DMing me your questions, your comments, problems, issues, concerns, disturbance, or say them with me. Probish condiments. That's right. I really love getting you guys mail and everything. So definitely keep that up. And then also looking for next Thursday's topics. So hit me with something good. Hit me with your best shot. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this show. Not going to be ready for Tuesday. And then if you're not following me on any of my platforms, I don't know why not. I'm such a positive force in this world. Don't you want the positive nature just surrounding you and taking you through your day so that you don't snap on anybody because you didn't take your medication today? You want me around. So you need to follow me on IG, Facebook, or Twitter at TheRealShotzie. It's down there somewhere. Yeah, I can see it down there. It's down there somewhere. So follow me, your girl, at TheRealShotzie on IG, Facebook, and Twitter. And check me out. Let me know what you're thinking. Give me Thursday's topics, people. All right, see you guys. Stay out of trouble. Love you. Mean it.